Right, so welcome here at Kerbal Space Center for my first commented videos in a couple of years, which will be the first one of a series of beginner tutorials for Kerbal Space Program. Because under my other videos, I have sometimes seen comments like, oh, I cannot even reach orbit, etc., etc. Which, in my opinion, is a bit sad, because I know that the learning curve of Kerbal Space Program is quite steep, especially taking into consideration that there is almost no tutorials included from the producers. So, yeah, I just thought I would take things into my own hands. And in this first episode, we will only take a look at the facilities here at the Kerbal Space Center and at the three different currencies that you have in the career mode game. So if you're playing in sandbox mode, which I expect from most new players, you can skip this first episode. And also if you play in science mode, you will only have science points and no funds and no reputation. And in my opinion, science mode is quite self-explaining, so I guess you can skip most, if not all, of this first video as well. So where was I? So yeah, talking about new players and sandbox mode, I don't even know if it is the best thing to do when you're new to just start goofing around in sandbox mode. Of course, it's nice to take a look on what you get, but by getting the largest and fanciest parts, of course you get tempted to do some very advanced constructions without even knowing the basics, and then you wonder why your shuttle is constantly flipping around. We will talk about that in the second episode. And it's better to start with small things. So, I don't know. Let's begin. So here we have this little information which only deals with how to move around the camera, which I guess everyone will figure out sooner or later. Sooner by just trying around, especially if you are used to some other video games. And so, and of course we can click away this explanatory windows, because that's what I'm doing here. So we will begin with the three different currencies, which are funds here on the left, reputation, and science points, as I also already mentioned maybe 2 minutes ago. So yeah, here we have 25,000 funds, and funds are like money. You can buy parts, or you have to spend funds for all your launches. It will calculate from the parts that you have built. Each of them has its own price, and then altogether it's the price of your launch. And also you can spend the funds in upgrading here, the facilities here. So let's just take a look. Everything here is at level 1, which you can see everything looks basic. The space plane hangar actually has a hole in its wall, and you can see just by the empty space that the space center is going to get bigger. And so upgrading facility is quite expensive, especially the research and development. We will talk about it later. So how do you get funds? By doing contracts. That's what the mission control is about, but again we will talk about the facilities very soon. So you have to do a bit of economies. Next one is the least obvious kind of currency, the reputation, which right now is at 0. You can see it can go even below 0, and it can go up to 100%. And you get reputation also by doing contracts. Especially if you have mods installed, you can get a huge amount of reputation by some contracts. And by doing things that have never been done before, like reaching orbit or landing the first Kerbal on the moon. So yeah, and of course you lose reputation for failing contracts or for losing Kerbals. And yeah, the last one is the science, which is the only one, as I said, that you will have in science mode. And you get science by doing experiments. And you can spend it in the tech tree to research more parts, which will lead us directly to the research and development, where you can see that tech tree, which right now we only have the point start researched by default in the beginning. And yeah, if you here we can see the parts that we have right now, but that we will again discuss in the second episode. And if you did some few experiments and got 5 science points, you can research the basic rocketry, or with also with 5 science points you can research the engineering 101. And in the end, the most expensive tech tree nodes will cost 1,000 science points. But this is only the stock tech tree. I am used to playing with 1 million, or it feels like 1 million mods, including the community tech tree, and then it will get like all this. And yeah, I removed all my mods for doing this tutorial, and so I'm doing them while waiting for Copernicus to be updated to 1.8.1. And also I'm considering to, but let's talk about that later. So yeah, and talking about the science points, you can also take a look here in the archives and see your the science experiments that you have done before, so assigned to all the celestial bodies where you have done them. But of course now I just started this new save a few minutes ago. We didn't even fly yet, so it is completely empty. And by the way, I also want to excuse my hilarious accent. Quite aware of that. So yeah, that concludes the research and development department. And as I've said, you can upgrade the facilities. And by upgrading, you will increase the amount of science that you can research. And also, with level 2 research and development, you can take surface samples. But yeah, I would guess you will figure all that out when you start playing. So, yeah, and research and development is closed in sandbox mode, but in science mode, of course, it is open. So, yeah, I don't know. Let's continue with the other two facilities that you will also have in sandbox mode, except for the VAB and the SPH, because we will talk about them in the second episode. So, yeah, no, got it, because I will explain it. So here in the tracking station, you can take a look at all the celestial bodies and at your spacecrafts, which now, of course, is nothing because we didn't launch anything yet. And yeah, with these buttons down here, you can, if you select one spacecraft, you can fly it, you can terminate it, meaning to say destroy, or you can recover it if it is landed at Kerbin. So, that concludes the tracking station. And we will go to the third facility that you will have in sandbox mode, which is the astronaut complex, where you can see your astronauts that you have. Here you can have your active carbonauts. Right now we have 4. All of them are available because no mission is flying. If we had a mission flying, you could see them here. If you lost a Kerbal, you would see it, or you would see him or her here. And yeah, because if you crash something and it will say like Jebediah Kerman was killed, he will just be lost and eventually find his way back here into the astronaut complex. Here you can hire new carbonauts, which, as you can see, is quite expensive. Especially, the cost will increase exponentially. So currently it's with 65,500 funds, not that expensive. 25,000 funds actually is quite a joke amount. Like the most advanced, or some of the most advanced high tech level parts are more expensive, just a single part. So, yeah, let's leave the astronaut complex, and by leveling it up, you will allow Kerbals to go on EVAs to leave their spacecraft, and also it will increase the number of Kerbals that can go there. So the last two facilities that we will discuss in this episode only are important for the career mode, which is the administration building, where you can select strategies. So this is more like into management and economics, where you can have, or basically with strategies, or most of them, you can trade one kind of currency to another one. Like the unpaid research program, here in the description it says it will hire some students or something that will do research for you, but they are not paid, and because they are not paid, you will lose reputation. And what it does is take reputation points that you get. Like I say, they are the least obvious kind of currency. I think I forgot what to say what they do, because they will the more reputation you have, the better contracts you will get, basically. The more and the better. So yeah, you can take like this strategy, which will turn each reputation point that you got into a dedicated amount of science points, and you can change that with the commitment. But to get higher commitment, you need to upgrade your administration building. And the second kind of strategy, I don't even know which one it is, but basically you can have another one that does the same thing. It will turn reputation into science, but you will just say like, boom, here you have 200 reputation points, and we will get that and that much science points right now, and it will only happen one time. Like here with the bailout grant, takes reputation and turns it into funds, which is quite obvious if you have to be bailed out. So also you can have some strategies that will take science into that will turn science into funds, which is what I always do in the later game. The early game, science points are very important to get progress, so I take reputation, which is not that important in the beginning of the game, and turn it into science. And later, when I have more science than I could ever spend, I take this the other strategy that will turn it into funds. Because, as I said, hiring Carbonauts gets increasingly expensive, and at some point with that is just insane, the cost. So, and there's some in the operations led by Gaskerman, there are some other strategies that do, like here they fit recovery transponders and increase the refunds for recovered parts, which of course doesn't really fit to the other two kinds of strategies that I mentioned before. So yeah, we can conclude or we can complete the administration building and head to the last facility, the mission control, where we can take these contracts that we mentioned before, and this will also basically lead us to the second episode. So yeah, here we can see right now we have four contracts available, all of them by the Kerbin World Record Keeping Society or something like that. And yeah, we have this task for the contracts, and we can accept or decline them. And yeah, which hold ah yeah now I got it again. So yeah, taking into consideration what we are going to do in the second episode, we can now take a look at the contracts that are available. Like orbiting Kerbin, as I said in the first minute, I got the inspiration to do this by people claiming that they cannot even reach orbit, which right now we could neither, because we don't have the parts available and not really the facilities, so it would be stupid to accept that contract. Similarly, escaping the atmosphere is quite easy, but still we don't have the necessary rocket motors or the necessary parts. But what we can do is launch our first vessel, because you just have to launch something. So we can just accept this contract. And what we can also do with our first launch is to take some scientific data. So now we have these two active contracts here. And if we achieve the goal of collecting data, we will get 6,400 funds. And similarly here we have 3,200 funds for launching our first vessel, which, like I say, both things we will do in the second episode that I'm going to record directly after this one. And I hope to see you again there. And if you liked it, you can leave a like and also take a look at this channel and my main channel. And if you like them, you can subscribe.